that are coming in to the rebels, or whoever you want to call those.
Well, the Kurds, the Kurds are getting their supplies through Turkey, you know.
The Syrian Free Army, whatever they call themselves.
Will that affect Thanksgiving? If ISIS takes Turkey, would that affect Thanksgiving? You know, turkeys?
I don't know, but do you know if there's any Italians who belong to the ISIS?
No.
Well, if they did, what would they be called? Italian ISIS.
Italian ISIS. I know you didn't think of that yourself. You must have heard it from someplace.
I don't have the kind of brain to think of that. You like it?
It sounds like something that one of the late night talk show hosts would come up with.
No, actually, that was thanks to our friend Jeff a while back. He told his girlfriend to ask us that. We didn't catch it, and it just went over our head.
I don't remember that joke being mentioned.
It wasn't a joke. All they said, he asked if there are any Italians in ISIS.
But did he say that it would have been Italian ISIS?
But no, he asked and it never went any further. That was the end of it. We just said no, we went to talk about something else. So then I guess it went over our head.
A lot of things go over our heads. That's why
hats.
I don't understand why
I've been wearing hats lately.
Well, in the wintertime, I always wear a hat because I am bald and, you know, let's face it, about 85% of the body heat escapes through the top of your head, and I have nothing keeping any heat in, so...
Yeah, that's true.
I just don't like to wear gloves because I don't like the feel, but hats I wear.
Okay. So you wear hats, but no gloves. We don't need any more.
You know, ladies and gentlemen, Felix and I don't understand why, if for no other reason, you don't call us, because there's so much that we don't know. Okay, and you can call up and make trumps out of us. That's not hard to do. Felix and I are begging to be made fools of. That's the point of this show. We want to entertain you. When I said, let me entertain you, I mean, I don't mind being the brunt of your jokes, believe me.
Yeah.
Okay?
You get mad if you're made fun of.
No, I get mad when people argue about my statistics and my point of view. But if they want to make fun of me, hey, that's cool.
Oh, but we can't make fun of how you feel? You're right, nobody else is right but you, is that it?
Well, most of the time, yeah. Yeah. The only time I'm ever wrong is when I argue with my wife and then I go...
You're never right, you mean?
No, yes, you're right. I'm never right. Yes, dear, you know.
Well, nobody's ever right when it comes to the wives. It's 12 noon. Let's go out. It's nice and sunny. It's dark outside. Okay, honey, it's not
they
sunny.
They call that night.
It's okay. You know, just if she says it's nighttime and it's 12 noon, I'll say, okay, you're right.
But it's true, ladies and gentlemen. Felix and I prepared a wonderful show on Friday about Halloween. We gave you an encapsulated lesson on the background of Halloween. And nobody bothered to call. And if they were out trick-or-treating... Nobody bothered to call to let us know how well they did.
But I did have people to discuss, call me afterwards and telling me that they liked our voices when we spoke like this. They thought it was pretty funny. Trick or treat, smell my feet. Oh, I heard somebody say that on TV today. Trick or treat, smell my feet.
Give me something good to eat. If you don't, I don't care. I'll pull down your underwear. And guess what? I'll be arrested as a pedophile.
Exactly.
You know, you got to be so careful what you say nowadays. It's terrible.
Oh, yeah.
I agree with her.
Just remember.
You see, we're on a mission from God.
Well, wrong show.
Well, you and I are always on a mission from God every Friday.
That's true.
Speaking of which, we want to remind you, Friday's show will go on as planned. The Rebellious Rev and the Doc. Topic, TBA, as most of our topics generally are.
Wait.
You have an idea? Isn't that psycho? Isn't that psycho?
Exorcist. Did we play that?
Oh, Exorcist, right.
Did we play that on Friday?
Oh, yes.
We did?
I think we did. Did we play the Monster Mash on Friday? I don't remember, by Zachary. I mean, that's a classic. But you're right. How could I forget that this is The Exorcist? Talk about scary movies, ladies and gentlemen.
Mark, you know if we have music, you can't talk because they can't hear. People can't hear you.
People don't listen to me when they can hear me anyway.
Oh, that's besides the point.
That's what you tell me. You tell me that all the time.
Which part? What do I tell you all the time?
You tell me that it's okay to talk when there's music playing.
I do?
Yes, and like a fool, I do, and no one listens to me. So what's the difference?
Well, no, I tell you to talk during... Not during a song.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I hate to sound like a timekeeper here, but it's 9:36, and not even a little tinkle on the phone, but get ready to listen to something.
No, not yet.
Well, I told them get ready. I didn't say it's going to go on immediately. See if you can remember this one. How many notes will it take you to...
It's going to take a long time for them to remember this one. It'll be half an hour before it comes on.
Really? Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, this is not something this is not something for this show. This is for next week's show.
From what?
Maybe for next week's show.
I could start singing it.
No, we don't want to do that.
We could do it together.
That's even worse.
You know, in those crazy voices of ours.
You think?
Yeah.
I was working in the lab late one night. When my eyes beheld an eerie sight, my monster from its lab began to rise. And suddenly, to my surprise,
He did the monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash. From my laboratory in the castle east, to the master bedroom and the vampire's feast, the jewels all came from their humble abode to get a jolt.
Happened to
might come out and say,
it's now the night.
It's now the moment, the man.
The month is out.
And it's a graveyard smash.
It's now the night.
It's the horn and the clown.
It's now the man.
It's now the monster man. Now everything's cool, that's a part of the plan. In my monster mash, it's the hit of the land. For you, the living, this mash was meant to. When you get to my door, tell them what it is.
Then you can mash.
Then you can monster man.
The monster mash.
And you might
have a dog, and you can mash.
You'll get all the
money.
Then you can monster man.
Why are you bothered? I'm talking to you. It's over.
So are we.
Oh, when did that happen? Do we have a moment?
We've been over 40 minutes ago. What are you talking about?
Do we have a moment of silence there for all the victims of
you
whatever?
You know what we should play? Our theme song. Silence is Golden by the Four Seasons, you know?
Did you hear, by the way, talking about the ISIS, as I told you before, they killed like 300 people today. ISIS.
What is it, a holiday?
No, I don't remember what they were, if they were Kurds or whatever. They called prisoners, children, women, adults, and they just blew them away. 300 of them today. When is the world going to realize this problem is not going to go away?
You know, on 60 Minutes, they had a... I wouldn't call him an imam, but he was a demonstrator, rabble-rouser from London. Said he wants to see Sharia law in every country around the world. You know, and he finds something wrong with every Western country. And there's nothing wrong with beheading people in the name of Allah, all right? It's the Muslim religion can't do anything wrong. I mean, this is truly frightening stuff.
Well, he was never really got convicted, I think, because he never recruited, he says he never recruited anybody, never told anybody to do anything.
Oh, you watched it?
Yeah.
You're right. He never did.
But he does. He is, I believe he is a Amma. What did they call them?
Yeah.
What do they call those? The priests?
An imam.
I believe he is an imam. But he's a dangerous character. Now, they interviewed some other guy, one of his followers. I didn't listen to him. Young guy. I don't know what he had to say.
He was the one who went around in the parks of London and everything, and he had an argument with a girl because her skirt was too short or whatever. I know what you're talking about. Oh, he was also arguing with a couple of young British, I don't know, they weren't teenagers, they were a little older, but they were drinking beer in the park at night. Okay. And of course, you know, you're not supposed to drink any alcoholic beverages.
Well, you know. But most of the imams in the UK are denouncing these people.
Right. But you know, the unfortunate thing is, all it takes is a couple of hotheads. You know, I mean, let's face it, that's how ISIS started.
Yeah, I was looking today, and they were showing a recruiting tape for ISIS, and they were playing it in a movie house, and there's all young kids there watching it.